I'm off to America to try and track down Craig David, who we've not heard from in a little while. Hello, taxi. Airport, please. There's been a lot written about him, but I want to find out the truth behind those headlines. In 2000, it seemed Craig David had the world at his feet. His debut album sold 7.5 million records, going multi-platinum in over 20 countries. But in 2005, his record sales were plummeting, with his third album hardly registering a hit. For some, including Craig, the blame was being firmly laid at the door of a certain large-headed rubber character.
Craig David!
Then came the stories that Craig had moved to America, that he was dating a string of supermodels, and also that he was gay. But who is the real Craig David? With unprecedented access to his home, work and social scene, I'll be following Craig to find out. My journey will take me coast to coast from LA to Miami, Craig's home in the US. All I'm hoping is I don't go, Craig David, please. This is Fern and Craig David. Los Angeles, and this is Sunset Boulevard. Craig David's hotel is right around the corner, and he just tweeted me, actually. It says, hey, Fern, I'm in LA. Do you want to hook up? Yes, I do. I'm on my way to meet Craig. I've got millions of things I want to ask him. I've also heard through the grapevine that the avid Mary and Beau Selecta character is still a bit of a touchy subject.
Proper bow, I tell thee.
As I found out when I saw this internet video of Craig's manager, Colin, earlier in my hotel room. In it, Colin berates someone from the record company's marketing team for blaming poor record sales on Beau Selecta.
But why am I listening to you talking shit? I'm sat here, you tell the f***ing artist, you tell the artist, not me, because you're f***ing in the room and he's in the room, all this bollocks that I'm having to listen to about Beau f***ing Selecta. Why are you telling me this like I've never f***ing heard it before? What's half? Beau Selecta, have I not heard before? How many people want to come up and go boink Craig David all over my boink? It's bollocks! If I'm going to pay you to do the job, then you better do it, because you can tell him why the we're wasting money. You're stupid. I don't want excuses. Excuses are what my kids give me when they don't want to go to bed. You get paid to do a job, so do it. I don't want to listen to this bollocks, okay? You sitting here, you tell him, because I'm not telling her anymore.
I mean, I shouldn't laugh because it's obviously touched a nerve, but I'm gonna go and meet him. Today, Craig's got a meeting in LA with his manager to talk about his up-and-coming new album. But before that, I've come to meet Craig at his hotel. Hello, Craig.
How are you, baby?
How are you?
Are you well?
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Are you all good and well and happy?
I'm good. You got my Twitter?
I got your tweet. That's why I'm here. I tweeted back.
I didn't get the
Twitter
back.
No, I tweeted back. I'll be round in a second. I was round the corner.
Where are you
staying? Here I am. I'm in a hotel not as posh as this around the corner.
How not as posh?
It's much less posh than this.
Does it have a bed in it?
I have a bed, but this is a lovely room. Wow.
It's nice, I mean.
Craig now spends most of his time living in the US, but I was surprised to hear about his living arrangements. So, you don't live here, you live in Miami?
I live London, still between London and Miami. Miami's really where, I mean, that's like my little manor now.
Yeah,
I've been there long enough to know like the place, but LA's still...
How long have you been in Miami for now, then?
Must've been about 2 years. I bought the place 2 years ago. It's the, you know the Sanderson Hotel in London? Same owners as that, that I bought, like, the Mondrian. They have, well, the Mondrian's down the corner, actually.
You know, so you live in a hotel?
Live in a hotel. Sometimes in
Birmingham. Wait a minute, Craig David. So you live, this is my actual dream. You live in a hotel where you have room service and then someone just comes and cleans your room every day, like, in a hotel?
It's pretty much, I try not to use that element, if I have to admit. The room service does, after a while, accumulate to, like,
a lot of money.
A lot of money after a while. So the fridge is now full of like my own stuff, and I'm thankful. I do have a housekeeper who comes up and does my place. that they love to charge a fortune in those hotels.
Of course. Living in a hotel in Miami, Craig's certainly come a long way from those early days growing up on a council estate in Southampton.
I like coming over here a lot. I find it quite an exciting place. Mm. Now that you live out here, do you find that's sort of died down a bit? Is it still got the same sort of sheen to it being in the United States, like the American dream? Are you living the American dream?
There's still a buzz, I think. I mean, there's like, Americans do like to celebrate success. That's one thing I can tell. It's a little bit different from back home. I know I've seen like guys in their car next to you, and you could be like driving with a girl next to you, and you're sort of going to dinner, and they'll be like, "Oh, lovely car, man. Love the car. Wow." Whereas back home, there'll be some sort of abuse that gets thrown at you. Something that just kind of, especially if you've got a girl next to you as well, just to kind of put you in place. You just think, "Why? Why now?" But it just
because they're jealous. Is that why?
There was a bit of jealousy, you know. But that's what I'm saying about culturally. I think that in America they embrace success.
But have you got a right flash car then?
I've got a Ferrari. Which
wow, okay.
But yeah. It was always like a dream to have a supercar like that, you know, a sport, proper sports car and a red, loud and proud Ferrari. The difference is, like I said, back in the UK, you'd go for maybe a black coloured Ferrari to tone it down to be like, you know what, okay, we'll get away with this. No. In Miami, it's like just go red, loud and proud. That's why you'll see yellow Lamborghinis, green Lamborghinis, because people just want to just live the dream.
Well, Craig certainly seems to be living the dream out here in the US, and quite a blinged-up dream at that. I'm off with Craig to meet his scary manager, Colin. Craig's been with Colin since the very start.
You're like Colin.
I'm just nervous.
Why?
Because I don't really usually get to... Yeah, and I don't hang out with music manager people, and I would say the sort of archetypal image of a music manager is someone who's quite scary.
No, he's straight up, because there's so many people that will feed you a whole load of fluff to kind of make you feel good. And you just, it doesn't help you any. I'd rather him say, you know what, really, let's pull down the faders on that and go again with the next record. At least I know where I stand, as opposed to having all these hopes and prayers that something's about to happen, you know?
After the relative failure of his last couple of albums, it's obvious Craig's desperate for another hit.
I just know that if I just keep staying in the studio and do what got me into this in the first place, which is writing songs, it'll all be cool. All the rest of it doesn't really mean anything. The LAs and the Miamis and the houses and all that stuff, I didn't have any of that when I wrote my first album, which is by far the biggest album I had. It was just about making music and being passionate as this young kid who just loved making songs. So if I keep that in my mind and remember that that's what got me here, the rest of it is immaterial, you know?
I'm here to learn the truth about Craig David. The last person I really want to meet is his manager.
I don't know why you got this thing where you think he's going to be, like, really, like, going to, rah, yeah, when you come through the door.
I've heard about him. I think it's going to be scary. Here we go. Do not disturb. He says do not disturb. Don't bloody hide.
Jack, how are you? You're right. Jack, this is Fern.
Hello, Jack.
Fern, this is Jack. This is Colin's son.
I was going to say, you did like a sort of music manager.
But he's a music manager, though. He has got a music manager sort of vibe going on.
Oh, man.
Colin.
Hello.
Colin.
Oh, look at this. Lovely, lovely.
How are you?
Very well, thank you.
You good? How's lovely?
Good to you.
Hello.
Fern,
how are you, Colin?
Good, how are you?
Good to meet you.
Good to meet you, too.
OK, so I'm going to be brave now and see if he really is as scary as I thought.
A lot of people these days think the music business is a sort of, like, amazing, glamorous, fun world, but, of course, there is such a harsh business side to it, and it is such a competitive industry that you have to be at the top of your game. And as you were saying, you can lose your nut. And when I Googled your name, I saw, like, a scary video of you shouting, and I was like, oh, my God, I'm going to be scared seeing that man. But that's when you have to cut to the chase and be business, right?
Yeah, absolutely. People think, you know, that and the bit you're referring to on YouTube is a bit like me throwing my toys out my pram. It's not. It's about somebody explaining something to me that was complete crap about an artist. If someone's going to dick around with my clients, then quite frankly, they're going to dick around with me first. The truth is, I'm very passionate about the people that I manage. So if someone's going to have a go at them, I'm going to have a go and I'm going to do my nut. And I have been known to do it in the past for that reason. But it's purely down to, I think, the passion. I believe in the people I represent, and if I didn't, I wouldn't represent them in the first place.
Whilst Colin heads back to London, Craig and I head off to his home in the US, Miami.
Do you know how with it, man?
I've got it, I'm there.
Sure?
I'm there.
With all of it?
Yeah, man.
That
bag lady, I'm used to
around.
It. This thing.
No, sure,
I'm not spoiling this look. This neat look. Seriously, I'll be fine.
Right, that looks so awkward. Just give the gold one. Just give the thing.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
What a gent. Look at this gent. That is a good look for you, Craig.
Great look, come on.
That is a good look for you.
Wow, we're in Los Angeles. You can get away with anything in this place,
well,
trust
this
me.
Well, this is so true.
First thing Craig has to do in Miami is pick up his car from the garage.
So here we are.
Are you buying a car?
No, picking up my car. It's the red.
No, is that your car there?
Yeah.
That's your car there.
Now, this being Craig, it's no ordinary car and no ordinary garage. Yes, Craig David keeps his red Ferrari in a car showroom.
All right, here we go. I've never even sat in a Ferrari before. This is, wow, I can sort of get used to this.
Full tank, everything. Thank you, brother.
Wow.
Straight.
So here we go. Craig's about to show me what lies underneath his bonnet.
I feel nervous for you. Just don't scratch it or do anything.
I'm in Miami, girl.
It must always be quite nice when you're driving along here, people look in and go, check the dude with the Ferrari. That's a nice feeling, right?
It is a nice feeling because there's a kudos that comes with a Ferrari, also the fact that it's red, and you're in Miami, and I think you have to embrace it or don't have the car.
Yeah.
I wouldn't do this in Park Lane in London.
And I imagine that the ladies quite like this car as well.
Yeah, girls do check it out, but I hope that I've got more to give than having to rock a car like this.
Yeah.
Miami, girl.
Here we are. My goodness me, I need to brush my hair.
We made it. Welcome to my
home.
Welcome
to your humble abode.
Yeah, this is home. Shall we go in?
Let's go in.
Come on.
Let's do it.
How you doing, man?
Welcome back, man.
You well?
Yeah, mate, great.
Wicked, brother. How you doing? You feeling? Wicked.
All right.
Yeah,
hello.
Wicked,
man. How are you doing?
Good, thanks.
Awesome. It's cool.
Craig has bought the penthouse apartment on the top of this hotel. So, technically, he lives in a hotel.
Oh, how exciting.
Peace.
See you in a bit, Craig.
No worries.
So this is... We've just arrived at Craig's house, which is a hotel, in a Ferrari. My mind has sort of gone scrambled. But, yeah, I'm going to get freshened up and then get ready for pre-dinner drinks at Craig's apartment on the very top of the hotel. Whatever next.
Coming up, I check out Craig's incredible pad.
You've got a jacuzzi on your roof!
Had to be done.
And we go out on the town. Mad.